beri ucap sebelum Hisham. So tadi saya sebenarnya perlu cakap sebelum Hisham, tapi saya kena beri Hisham dululah. Kerana biasanya kalau Hisham cakap lah, then semua orang balik. Selepas Hisham cakap, semua orang balik. So I thought that all of you will leave, but so that I don't have very much to say. But obviously all of you are. So obviously all of you are staying. You want to hear something, and I'm going to. Saya tidak akan memberitahu atau membuat jenaka, okay? Kerana isu-isu yang kita bincang sekarang sangat serius. Dan saya ingin menunjukkan satu slideshow berkenaan sistem demokrasi di Malaysia. Kerana kita telah bincang masalah-masalah undi, Kian Ming, kita telah bincang penipuan, kita telah bincang masalah-masalah berkenaan sistem pilihan raya. Ini adalah isu-isu kecil, tetapi bila ditambah, ini adalah satu masalah yang sangat besar. Sekarang saya ingin menunjukkan mengapa isu undi, mengapa undi kamu penting, dan juga mengapa undi kamu tidak penting. Dan ini mesej saya yang saya membawa kepada semua orang yang kita bincang bila kita bincang dengan undi Malaysia. Dan ini ditunjukkan melalui satu PowerPoint yang kita panggil the big picture. Kita melihat sistem demokrasi di Malaysia. Luis, cannot make it smaller. Okay, nevermind, just press it. Kita melihat sistem kita di Malaysia, ini negara Malaysia, dan Malaysia adalah terdiri daripada 28 juta orang. Bagaimana rakyat Malaysia diidentifikasikan? Kita melihat kita ada 51% jantina lelaki, 49% jantina perempuan. Ethnicity, bangsa, 67% Malay natives, 25% Chinese. I think we know all this, but let's go through it. 7% Indian and others 1%. We are then identified also by our religion in a lot of ways. 61% Muslim, 20% Taoist, Buddhist, Confucianism, Christians 9%, Hindu 7%, and others about 3%. Next. And we are also identified by our age. So if you look at the young below 24 years old, it's 60% of Malaysians. The young below 24 years old make up more than half the population. And below 15 years old, 28%. This is important, and bear this triangle in mind. We are also divided up by social income groups. Some people call it class. And Malaysia's income inequality is very, very high. So you have at least 40% who are lower income, 55% who are middle class, and I see there are a lot of people, especially in JB, who are at that part. 4% elite and the 1% super elite. The 4 plus 1 are really the elite group. Just remember that and keep that in mind. But the 40% are people who earn less than 1,500 per household or 4.4%. That is basically a number that is being used. Government uses, of course, a lower number, but it's not realistic, 600, 700 million. So what is the message? But before we go to that message, let us understand bagaimana sistem demokrasi atau sistem pilihan raya atau sistem negara ini dilaksanakan. So pertama sekali, kita ada satu perlembagaan. Perlembagaan itu undang-undang yang paling tinggi di negara kita. Di bawah perlembagaan itu ada yang di-Pertuan Agong, ada sistem kehakiman. Sistem kehakiman ini mempunyai mahkamah-mahkamah persekutuan, mahkamah rayuan, mahkamah tinggi. Terdapat satu ketua, ketua Chief Justice, ketua hakim negara yang that heads the judiciary. Dan ini juga penting. Siapa yang melantik ketua ini adalah yang di-Pertuan Agong di bawah nasihat Perdana Menteri. Selepas itu, kita ada institusi yang lain, Kabinet, Eksekutif, Government. Kita ada 28 minister, 40 deputy ministers. We have about 24 ministries and one PM department. Dan kita tahu ada Perdana Menteri yang mengetuai Kabinet. Perdana Menteri ini juga mengetuai Parlimen. Kerana kamu hanya boleh dilantik atau dipilih sebagai Perdana Menteri jika kamu mempunyai sokongan majoriti di Parlimen. So terdapat 222 ahli Parlimen. Readers, move it. Continue. Yep, next. So 222 members of Parliament by your one vote each. That is the three main institutions. Apart from that, what are the other institutions that influence us? So we have political parties, of course. Next. We have our culture, shared culture. Next. We have NGOs. Next. We have statutory bodies. We have the MACC, we have the Bar Council, we have Suan Kam. These are bodies that influence us. Next. We have about 165 statutory bodies in Malaysia. We have education, we have universities, we have colleges, we have schools. All these influence us. Next. And then we have businesses. We have a lot of big businesses around the country that influence us, where we buy and sell things and they provide services. Next. And earn profits. Then of course we have the old and new media. Kita ada media baru dan media lama. Surat khabar, internet. Kesemua ini, next. Kesemua ini memberi kesan. Okay, stop there. Kesemua ini memberi kesan kepada kami sebagai rakyat. Dan kita pergi sebagai rakan saya Hishamuddin tadi kata, kita ada prosedur di mana kita pergi mengundi satu kali 5 tahun. Ya? Everybody thinks that is very important. I am saying it's very important, yes, but it's also not important. Why am I saying that? Next. Once every 5 years, we elect cabinet, we elect government in the sense that we elect Move on. Once every 5 years, we elect 222 members of parliament. The prime minister that leads parliament also leads cabinet. And then cabinet advises the king as to who runs the judiciary. So in that sense, it's important. Yeah? But do these institutions really represent us? Do they still represent us today in view of our growth and our population? Who controls all these institutions? Why do I say they don't represent me? They may represent you if you think so, but they don't represent me. Who controls all these institutions? Who controls all these influences? And who controls all these things? Stop there. Who controls all these groups? Who controls parliament? Who controls the legislature? Who controls the judiciary? Who controls the MACC? Who controls the police? Who controls Suhakam? Who controls all these people? Even though you have your one vote, are you able to control these institutions? No, right? Okay. I ask you now, if we look at it in terms of income group, next. Yeah. Please, President. More than before that. Before that, okay. One more time. Yeah. sorry, this is a draft that we're working on. But in terms of the income group, the triangle, Luis, show the triangle. This triangle, where do the people that control parliament, judiciary and cabinet come from? Do they come from the bottom 40%?
No.
Do they come from the middle 55%?
No.
Where do they come from? Where do the people who control your institutions like MACC, when they get appointed, where do they come from? Who controls Suhakam? Who controls your universities? Do you know your minister, your minister of higher education appoints at least 4 different people in every public university? That he has a hand in almost every major appointment in universities? Who controls your education that feeds you the information? Who controls the media? Do the bottom 40% control the media? The people that control the media linked to political parties? All these important institutions I went through just now, ask yourself who actually controls the country. And when people say democracy is a tyranny of the majority, I say it's nonsense. It's tyranny of the minority. Because it's that top 5% that controls all your institutions. And you may think that your vote once every 5 years is important. Yes, I say it's important. I'm not saying don't go out and vote. Please come out and vote in full force. But it is time that we start talking about systemic change. Not changing personalities only. I'm not saying who to vote for. I'm saying it's time that we start thinking about moving away from this system. That this system no longer represents the minorities. They no longer represent the orang asli. Ask yourself, how many orang asli members of parliament are in parliament? Ask yourself, how many young people, 60%, are in parliament? Ask yourself, how many women are in parliament when there are 49% women in Malaysia? Is this representative democracy? So what are we talking about? When we talk about procedural type of election, we are also talking about fast. So when politicians tell you that you must go and vote, and yes, go and vote, in the end, it's about taking that power. But when you say kuasa rakyat, apa ni makna kuasa rakyat? Sebenarnya apa tu kuasa rakyat? Kuasa rakyat itu satu pilihan raya, satu kali 5 tahun untuk masalah-masalah orang, 365 hari satu tahun. And your voice only once every 5 years? If that is your voice, then you take it. To me, that's not my voice. And bagi kita, kita mesti buat benda-benda yang akan memberi lebih tekanan kepada orang yang menguasai institusi-institusi ini. Memberi tekanan kepada 5%. Because the democracy in all over the world is now becoming the tyranny of the minority. The rich, the super elite and the super class. And they talk to us about race and religion. It's not about race and religion. It's about them making as much money as they can and then controlling the institutions to stop us from growing. And that's why they are afraid when the people rise up and say, let's go duduk bantah. Let's buat protest. Kita buat semua ini, mereka takut. Mereka kata ini Yahudi. Ini benda-benda tak baik. Ini benda tak bagus. Kerana kita, itu sebenarnya kuasa rakyat. Itu sebenarnya, aktivisme oleh rakyat, itu sebenarnya kuasa rakyat. Dan itu yang Bersih telah buat. Itu yang banyak-banyak kumpulan di seluruh Malaysia telah buat. Dan itu benda yang sangat-sangat penting bagi masyarakat yang akan datang, bagi remaja-remaja yang akan datang. And if you have time, spend some time with us on the booth. We explain to you what we do. We are not here to say only go out and vote. We are also here to say, let's talk about changing the institutions, taking away power from the Prime Minister, taking away power from the King, taking away power using amendments to the Constitution, going for proportional representation, going for town hall meetings like this, going for moving towards people assemblies, where the people actually decide, not the 222 idiots that sit in Parliament and think they know better than all of us. So we are talking about systemic change. I'm not interested, and that's why Barisan Nasional and Pakatan Rakyat will not and do not like what we say and what I say. Because whoever comes into power will not want this systemic change. Because there's so much power concentrated in the executive now that whoever takes power, they have a few days. And I'm saying because the system is already like that, siapa-siapa yang menguasai sistem ini tidak akan memberikan apa-apa kuasa balik. Jadi kita seharusnya sekarang berbincang, memberi tekanan kepada semua parti politik untuk memberitahu kami, memaklumkan kami sama ada mereka akan cuba dengan kami, dengan rakyat menukar sistem. Dan apa mereka akan buat untuk menukar sistem, menukar institusi-institusi macam ni, di mana kuasa terlalu banyak dalam tangan satu orang. Itu ni message yang saya nak membawa. Minta maaf, I'm sorry I'm over time. I'm sorry if you are a bit depressed. Tetapi dalam aktivisme kita cuba membuat orang sangat sedih. Kalau orang tak sedih, kalau orang tak marah, mereka tak akan keluar. Mereka tak akan duduk bantang, mereka tak akan protes. Kalau orang tak marah, kalau orang tak sedih dan kalau orang tak menanya soalan-soalan untuk kebaikan negara ini, nobody will do anything. So today, yes, our purpose and my purpose and everywhere we go is to make you depressed. But we have also solutions. It's just that we need time to talk about this, and if you are interested, let's work together for a better Malaysia. You know.
Thank you, Edmund. Are you depressed? Are you sad? Don't be, because you're here. Semua ada di sini, tak payah.